Hi, I'm Gabby.
And I'm KD.
I'm from Brazil.
And I'm from the U.S. And we are an international couple here to give you free game, some things that may be helpful starting this whole process of being married with one another.
Mm-hmm. And today we're going to talk about the green card, the monster
it
of
is.
Immigrants.
It can be a very, very, very stressful task. Really, if you have points lined out and have a good guide, it can be relatively stress-free. Like she said, we're going to give you some tips and pointers, and first thing we want to go over are the different forms that you will need. Some forms may not apply to you, some forms didn't apply to us, but we still want to go briefly over it so you know what you need to submit.
The majority process, KD was responsible to do it, because first it was English. Yes, I speak English, but as you can see, sometimes my English is a little bit broken.
Yeah.
And second, the cost. And man, I'm from Brazil. I still have things in Brazil, but I don't receive in dollars. The cost can be really, really high if you don't plan the best way.
Mm-hmm.
So this is why we are here to help you.
So the first form is one you probably don't hear much about, the G-1145. That form tells the United States government that you want to be notified when they receive your documentation after you send it in. All they ask for is your phone number, email address. You'll get a text message. Like, I got a text message the day that they received the form. The next one is the I-130 is basically for me, saying that I am petitioning for her to come to the United States and have a green card visa. The cost of this form is $535, right? You need basic information. All the forms is really just basic information. There's no need to go in depth about things you'll need for the actual form itself. It's just important documentation that we'll go over later. After that, you have the 130A, which is another quick form that is for her to fill out saying that she's applying with me, okay? Cost of this form is nothing. It goes along with the 130 form. Okay. After that, you have the I-485, which is the petition to adjust your status. Okay. So, slight background. She came here originally on a tourist visa. This application says is that she's changing that visa from a tourist visa to a green card visa. Now, if you are, for instance, don't have a tourist visa, wanting to get married to an American citizen, and you want to come to the United States, you have to apply for the K-1 visa. Shout out 90 Day Fiance and all that.
Where's my flowers?
And then once you come here and you get married, then you can submit this form in order to adjust status from K-1 to green card spousal visa.
Yeah, and just because I already had the B1, B2 visa, is the tourism visa, essentially, I didn't apply for the K-1. It doesn't make any sense for you to apply a K-1 if you already have a visa to get inside U.S. Is right, get inside the U.S.?
To enter the U.S.
To enter the U.S. Don't worry about that. Don't think that if you are crazy about 90 Days Fiancé like we are, we like to watch, okay?
Flowers.
Don't judge us. Yes, a guilty pleasure. Probably you think, oh my god, I need a K-1 visa. No, if you already had a tourist visa.
Right.
But make sure that you have everything sent to the immigration office for the expiration the immigration give to you. So, for instance, in my case, when I arrived at the airport, they give me 6 months to stay legal in U.S. like a tourist. But in this time, we get married and we had all the documentation that we need, and we sent before the time that the immigration gave to me to stay legal in U.S. If you start this process after this date, probably you have some problems with immigration.
It should be noted, though, even though it's frowned upon about waiting after the date that she mentioned, doesn't mean that if you are past the date, that is 100% guaranteed that they're going to deny your application.
But it's better to do before.
Of course it's better to do before, but it doesn't mean it's like, oh my gosh, what am I going to do? Like,
yeah.
Just go through it. Don't get stressed. Move forward. Things happen. They understand that. Again, other visas that you could be here for is a student visa for school, maybe here working, whatever the case may be, and you go the route of trying to get a green card through marriage, you need to submit this I-485 form. And the cost of this I-485 form is really two parts. First, you have pay $1,160 that goes towards the application itself to adjust the status. And then another $85 that you pay for your biometric exam. So basically, biometric is when you get your fingerprints, you get pictures made, all that type of stuff. In fact, we are going to go there today. We're in that part of the process for her to get all of her biometric stuff submitted at the nearest field office, which happens to be in Atlanta, Georgia. Between the I-130, I-485, total cost that we incurred, or that anybody really in this process should incur, is $1,760. So just letting you know, if you need a total sum, that is pretty much where you're at, $1,760. There are certain other costs that could be incurred. We're going to discuss later. One to be in the next one. The next form you have to submit with the packet is the I-693, which is basically a physical that the person applying to get their status adjusted must go through. So you have to find a registered USCIS civil surgeon to conduct your exam. You can go on USCIS website in order to find the nearest doctor to you that can complete that part of the exam. It in itself can be a chore, okay?
Mm-hmm.
One, before you go, I highly recommend, if you have just gotten married, don't jump and do this before you can have some type of insurance or anything, just in case you may run into some issues with exam costs and getting some types of vaccinations.
Yes.
All that stuff can be costly, like $1,000 costly. So I would recommend make sure you at least have insurance just in case. It may not help, but it definitely helped. It helped us.
Yeah, of course, this assurance can also help you have a proof.
Yeah, we'll get to that later, but it definitely helps give evidence that your marriage is legit and that you're not trying to just marry somebody.
It's
and
not
give
a
them
scam.
A
it's not
scam.
A scam, yeah. Right? It's not a scam, right? Okay.
The way that the medical exam goes is that once you find the doctor, you'll call and set up an appointment. You'll go in to do the initial part of the exam where you submit the information, all your vaccination records that you already have. Another key point that we'll kind of get into more later is having those vaccination records translated and everything. So basically, there's a list on the website that tells exactly what vaccinations you need, and if you don't have, you will need to get. You yeah. might as well go ahead and go through that list and check everything off and make sure you have the records that you will need, like from birth. Okay.
And if you are from Brazil, please use the system in Brazil, the health system in Brazil, so you can get the vaccines for free and just have the record that you got the vaccines, okay? Have in mind that some vaccines, maybe you need 1, 2, 3 doses, like hepatitis B or even COVID, okay? So just make sure that you got all the vaccines that you need in Brazil, because, you know, in Brazil, we don't need to pay for that vaccines. And right here, you just need to prove, no, I already had this, my proof. And if you want to be 100% sure that they will understand, have a translation. I have some information about companies that can translate documents for you and send you online. And I will put everything in the description link.
The first, like I said, the first appointment is just basically to give them your information. Then typically within 8 days, if everything's all right, they'll schedule the next appointment and you go in for your actual physical. Physical doesn't take long, and when you finish it, the doctor, the civil surgeon, will give you the I-693 in a sealed envelope and an additional copy. Do not open the sealed envelope, okay? You take that sealed envelope. I mean, you may think some official U.S. stamp seal. No, it's literally an envelope with a piece of tape over it and his signature.
That's it.
Yeah, so be careful. Don't, like, accidentally just shove it anywhere and it opens up, because you got to do it all over again. And then you submit that sealed I-693 with the application pack. Another thing to know is the cost. Typically, it can vary from doctor to doctor. The cost generally for us was $200 in this area, and some other doctors that we checked were around that same price. So expect an additional $200 plus whatever occurred cost between examinations and vaccinations. Next one is the I-864, and that basically is a document saying, It's an affidavit of support. So basically it says that I have the funds to support this woman while she's here in the United States. And they'll ask for things about your previous income for the last 3 years,
where you were,
job status, all things like that. Again, it's pretty straightforward information, but this is the part of the document where it could vary, because if you aren't in a stable job or whatever, or have non-typical means of income, you have to prove to them that you make so much money in order to take care of the person. Otherwise, if you can't do it, you will need another person to sponsor. They want to make sure that somebody is able to take care of whomever they're allowing to stay in the country for that amount of time.
Yeah.
The last thing we submitted was the I-131, which is basically the travel document. So basically, the green card process could take a long time, okay?
6 months, 1 year, two, depending. Because people that started the process before pandemic, they still waiting for that, you know?
So if you submit an I-131, it basically gives you a card that you can use to travel outside the country. Because if you submit your green card application, leave the country, they automatically assume you've abandoned that application and terminate that whole process. You lose all the money you submitted and everything. So once you start the process, you're not allowed to leave the United States. Mm-hmm. Only way you're able to leave is if you submit this document and they give you a card saying that this person can leave and come back. Green card process still underway, in process. And that's all the forms, the official forms that we submitted. There is another one that I want to go over, is the I-765, which is the employment authorization form. So basically, it will allow you to work in the United States before your green card is approved. Like I said, it can be a long time before your green card is actually approved, and this will give you authorization to go ahead and work sooner than the green card approval. What she does, she has her own business, works remotely from home, and it's not like it's necessary.
Emergency.
It's not an emergency for her to work right now, so it was no need for us to submit that particular document. Typically in the past, I know things have kind of changed. That document with the travel document go hand in hand, and they can give you something that's called a combo card that works for both to work and to leave the country and come back. But again, we didn't need that. Only thing we were really worried about is the travel part of it, because we're trying to go home for Christmas.
Yes. But one thing about this document is, like KG said, if you really think that you need to get work, not only for the money, but make your mind health, because it can be a tough process, you know, especially for a person that is waiting to be somebody here, because you don't have any document, you don't have anything, you can move around. So it can be very difficult if you are alone here, so you are far away from your friends and family, especially you're from Brazil, so you know what I mean. And can help you in this process to adapt in US. In my case, like KD said, I had something going on in Brazil, so I have a routine to work, even if I am at home. So it helps a lot in your mental health. Bless you. We have a dog, and we forgot to say that, but we have a dog. But that's it, okay? Have this in mind.
Okay. So now we're going to get into some of the supporting documents that you need to submit with those forms that you've completed. First of which is the I-94. So I-94 basically is the form. You can go online to a website, print it out, and it shows every time that she's entered and left the country, okay? Mm-hmm. That's all it shows, and you can print it out real easy, stick it with the application.
This I-94 is very easy, like KD said, but can be a little bit tricky. Have in your mind that sometimes the immigration, I don't know, they understand that we in Brazil, we have name, middle name, and last name, right? So for instance, Gabriela Tanana Tanana, two last names, I would say that. Sometimes the immigration put your middle name together with the last name. So when you billing out the application, make sure that it's the same name that you have in your passport. So probably you take a look at your passport, first name and last name, they be together. Okay, so you can try some things, and because sometimes you can, oh my god, I'm not in the system. No, you are. You just try to put together or separate. It will work. It's very easy, and the link to fill The form I will put right here in the description, okay?
Next one is pretty easy, is each of you have to submit 2 passport style photos. Personally, here in the United States, I know Walgreens is probably the quickest and easiest option, so that's what we use. Just go into Walgreens, take a picture of you for each of us.
How much was it?
It was about
$30?
$30 for both, so about 15 per person. From my end, they do require, it says passport or birth certificate. You can submit both if you want to, if there may be any discrepancy of whether you're a U.S. citizen or not, but I just submitted my passport. Important point. When you submit the application, you can submit photocopies of all the documents that you have. Not until you have an actual interview way later in the process do you have to bring those actual documents with you. So as long as you get good photocopies of your passport or whatever else you need to submit, it's good to go for the actual submission of your green card application. She had to submit a copy of her passport.
And visa.
So with her, she had to submit the biographical page, then the page that showed the latest stamp coming into the United States. And in her case, the visa is in a separate passport because of how things work there. So I had to take a picture of the visa page from that passport. So 3 different forms of identification. On top of that, she also had to submit her birth certificate. And the birth certificate, Long story.
But the point is, I didn't have my original birth certificate and even a copy. The copy that I had, it was a picture and it was really bad. So in my point of view, I thought that it won't be important to have the birth certificate, okay? But I was wrong. So in the last minute, almost, I realized that in Brazil, they have a website. I'll put the website right here below in the description of the video, but it's the official website of the government and you submit all the information. So it doesn't matter that if you don't have your birth certificate anymore, or even if you are living in the US and you didn't bring with you your birth certificate, you also can ask for that. Of course, you need to pay. In my case, I asked for a digital one, birth certificate, and also the original that they sent by mail in Brazil. So I asked to send to my mom's house and mom sent to me to US. Everything costs 300 reais, okay? So have this in your mind if you want the digital copy and the original copy. And also, you need to translate some documents.
And another thing in our case, and something that you may have to submit, is that she has been married before. So she had to get the divorce document and submit it with the application as well. And that had to be translated. So all those official good documents you have to submit at the time of your application. Next thing that you need to do is get you affidavits of support. So basically, letters of support is a standard document that you can find and use. But basically, you want to get people that you know and know you as a couple, not individually, but as a couple, to basically give a testament that you are a legit couple. So we got 3 just for good measure, but really all you need is 1, if any, that you can get. And whoever does it, they need to have it notarized. So basically, you need to go to somebody official that says that they are actually attesting to whatever they said in that document. It could be family members. In fact, it's encouraged to have family members do it. And then also close friends and people. Like I said, as long as they've seen you together as a couple, good to go. Another thing, pictures of your life together. You know, basically how y'all met, all this stuff. Wedding day photos help. Anything that shows you doing
Christmas, Thanksgiving,
family things with each other. You want to submit those pictures. Again, clear copies like in PowerPoint with the name, date, and time on the bottom of the slide, that works, and you can submit that all together. We did about 6 to 8 pictures just to put in there. Don't submit a whole album.
No, please.
And don't put actual photos, because like USCIS likes everything very neat. So if you try and submit photos and they're all over the place, it gets thrown away anyway, probably. And then the last supporting document is kind of going back with the affidavit support, that I-864, I think. Yeah, I-864. With all the information about employment and history, you need copies of your W-2 and your 1040, basically for the last 3 tax years. And also a letter of employment from your employer. All that should be relatively easy to get through your company. But basically, all those supporting financial documents you would need to get as well in order to submit with the application. And I think that's pretty much it.
Yes. Well, as you can see, it's a long process, okay? Can be tough mm-hmm. have this in your mind, can be very stressful. Both of us, it doesn't matter if you are the responsible to fill all the forms or not, but make sure that you are doing this together. You are on this journey together, okay? Because it can be very, very stressful, this process. But as soon as you send the package, you just can come back and brief again, okay?
Oh, another thing is sending the package. You want to put a cover letter with all the things that you want to be including, numbered, and then you want to put tab markers on the bottom of the page to indicate what part of the packet it corresponds with whatever's on your cover letter. Then you want to not staple, but paperclip the documents together, put it in an envelope to send. You can go to a USPS post office to submit the documents, tell them that you want to send it to this location. Another thing, we'll put a link below for the USCIS website. They basically tell you if you live in this part of the country, this is where you should send it to. They have certain lock boxes for certain areas of the country. I think it's only three. So majority of the east portion of the country will send it to Chicago. And you submit it and send it, and then when they receive it, because you submitted the form I told you, they'll give you a text message when they get it and let you know what your PD post date is.
Yeah, and make sure that the form that you use is not old, because every year they update the form, okay? Go with the official website of the government that we, as KJ said, we put here and below, and make sure that you're using the right and valid form, because if you don't use, can delay your process, and you don't want that.
Now, after her biometric appointment, from the research we've done, it can take like a year after this.
Yeah.
It can take a long time. So making it to this point is pretty good, pretty fast once you submit your application. But after this, it can be...
We don't know.
The only thing kind of hope for and pray for is that the travel document comes before Christmas.
Yes.
It's really all that matters at this point.
I want to go to Brazil.
I want to go back.
So bad. Pão de queijo. Açaí. You know, if you're Brazilian, you know what I mean. And if you're Brazilian, please let us know. If you are from the south of US, let us know. Mm-hmm. Who knows, someday we can meet each other. We love to go to Brazilian restaurants sometimes, you know, to eat a brigadeiro, a coxinha, churrasco, and everything like that. So let us know where you're from and how you met each other. If your husband and wife is from US and if you're from Brazil, let us know. We want to know about your history too. And we really hope that this content right here can help you. As you said before, we are here like we are black couple living in US, from Brazil, from US, giving you the perspective about the world. And of course, give you some tips to make sure that you don't have a lot of struggle.
Yeah.
In this process, this can be very heavy. Okay?
Free game for your life. So
exactly.
That's it. We'll see you.
Yeah. Beijo.
Ciao, ciao.